Yes, so this is a work by my PhD student Dario Garagliotti, who did an internship at Signal. And I don't know if you have heard about Signal, but it's a media monitoring company. So one of the services they have is, as a company or as an individual, you could subscribe to a service where basically they mine what is being said or written about you. And they do that by analyzing news streams. One difficulty there is with long-tail entities that they don't really have any information about them. They don't have a Wikipedia entry. All you have is a name, maybe a few service forms of the entity, different names by which it's mentioned, and maybe a short textual description. So, by normally, you would rely on entity linking techniques to find mentions of a given entity. Here you need to do something different. So, the problem is, given an entity, we want to retrieve a set of contexts, and in this case, contexts will be sentences. So we want a ranked list of sentences that mention the entity, highly relevant to that entity. So imagine the example where we have an entity called ISAI, which is an investment fund. And there's also a movie, an Indian movie with the same name. And if you just do a simple string matching, then you retrieve these two sentences. And only one of them would be relevant to this investment fund. So what we want to do is, given an input entity, we want to rank the sentence that is relevant about an entity higher than other sentences that mention the name of the entity. All right. So this is difficult because of lack of existing knowledge-based entry. So the main idea in this work is to use other entities, well-established entities, that are in some way similar to the input entity, and leverage the context of those support entities to help rank context for the input entity. I will illustrate this with the running example. So here is the input entity design, and the support entity ranking component identifies entities that are similar to this input entity. Then support context ranking returns a set of contexts for these support entities. And then a context-to-context ranking estimates the importance of the support context to help rank context for the input entity. So basically, instead of going from left to right, immediately we take this detour to first to support entities and to support context and then back up. And this whole approach is captured in a probabilistic framework, which I'm not going into detail here, but I just want to point out the three main components. I will say a little bit about the estimation of those components. And the other thing I want to highlight is the two summations. So you see the first summation is over the supporting entities, and the second is over the supporting context. So this is something you can control, how many supporting entities you want to incorporate and how many supporting contexts. So we have these three main components. The first one is support entity ranking. So that's an entity, a standard entity retriever problem. In this work, we use BM25 for ranking entities, and we use the description of the input entity as the query. And then we rank other entities. So the supporting entities are well-established entities. They have Wikipedia pages. So we score the Wikipedia pages against this description. And additionally, you can incorporate other signals, for example, the popularity of these entities or industry to certain types. And there is that cutoff parameter which controls how many support items you want to take into account. The second one is ranking contexts for these support entities. And again, remember that these support entities are well-established entities, so we can actually annotate the collection with them, and using standard entity linking approaches, and we can use the entity linking confidence score for estimating that probability. And the last component is context to context ranking. So given a supporting context, how similar this is to the context we want to score for every input entity. And we can measure that similarity two ways, using a simple retrieval-based approach, so just BM25 and using the context as the query, or what performs better is to do semantic matching, so we represent the two contexts using embedding vectors, and then we measure the precise similarity of those vectors. Okay, the one main contribution of this work is the test collection. These are actual entities that were of interest to this company. 165 entities in total, and 73 of them didn't have a Wikipedia page at the time of writing. And then for each of these entities, contexts are ranked using different methods, and we apply standard pooling techniques. And then there are these media experts who actually do this online reputation management task, and they look at each of these contexts and assign a binary label whether that is relevant to that entity or not. I will just show one table with the results showing mean average precision scores. And the first line is entity linking using an entity linker. And what you can see immediately is that, well, it at least does something, but it doesn't do very well for entities in Wikipedia, but it cannot do anything with entities that don't have a Wikipedia page, obviously. Then there is a support sentence retrieval baseline from Blanco and Zaragoza of CIGA 2010, which is an IR approach, and that does much better than entity linking. And then there is the best configuration of our method. So what you can notice is performance doesn't drop for entities that don't have a Wikipedia page. Actually, on the contrary, this is not something unique to our approach. I mean, retrieval-based approaches do have this property, whereas entity linking approaches fail. But in general, the take the big message is that leveraging these supporting entities and their context helps a lot. Okay, so there are a couple of possible follow-up applications for this. One is that since we can identify these supporting contexts with very high precision, they could possibly be used as weakly labeled instances in training an entity linker model. So that it should be possible to actually train a model for long tail entities without having to label any instances manually. And of course, you can also use this context retrieve to augment entity profiles. That was it. I will see you at my posters.